Dr Kay's work and watched it develop over the years. Well, not over the early years, so I didn't know it then, but over the last decade or so. And yeah, just love her work. So we're really pleased to have a solo show for Kay. It's for Kay. It's her first solo show here. So yeah, I won't jabber on. I'll hand you over to Dr Felicity Haynes, who's going to do the opening speech.
I can't tell you what pleasure it gives me, not to open this, that's fun too, to drive into Margaret River and see Kay's owl confronting you. It is absolutely gorgeous. I think it ought to stay there permanently, actually. Because I have an obsession with owls, and that one's really like the one that I've got in my bedroom. It's absolutely gorgeous. So I just adore owls. People who know me in my property out of Tindred know that I've got little ceramic sculptures and little pictures everywhere, pig nose. I'm obsessed with them. Why? That's not to say that the other birds here aren't important. But, you know, emus can't avoid looking slightly ridiculous. And I was going to make a joke about silly coots, and I find they're not coots, they're swamp hens. But they're beautiful, and they're accurately portrayed. But there's something about, and I love all the red birds too, and blue rings. I like meeting all the birds here. But the ones that keep on pulling me back are the owls in this corner. There's something magic about them. And one of the things I've noticed about Kay is all her work is about its place in nature. But these more recent ones, this one out of here, I love because they're becoming more magic. I mean, I think the poetry in that one is extraordinary. It's not to say these aren't spiritual and magic in their own way, but that one dances to me. It just has that quality of unearthliness that these ones possess. Earthliness is a good quality, but that one is just lovely. Well done. So, I can't cast emus seriously. I do care to take cockatoos seriously. But I care for owls.
Speak up.
They just speak to me. And 28s. There was one of 28s here. I'm sorry, I don't like 28s. I can say that. But that's that right. Okay. One of the things that strikes me about this is, 28s, and you all laugh because you know 28s. Yes. They're scavengers. They're beautiful, but they're scavengers. They destroy my fruit. Just as it's getting ripe. Watch the locusts. They know exactly when you need them there for one more day, and they'll get them that night. So Kay knows the local birds. She's lived in this place for over 40 years, and knows the sense of place that comes through all of this. These are our birds. They belong here. I've only come down to Margaret River in the last 10 years, but already I can associate with these. They're part of my environment, my living environment. I love that she learned to love birds from her mother, and there are some visual diaries over there, but the book, the uncle published the birds in Australia book. So she knows about them. And that's the curious thing. These are, most of them, illustrators. They're accurate. They're what the birds are like. I love this Carnegie over here. That this is almost reminiscent of a John Gould painting. It's illustrative. And that's important, that the artist has the technique to make us recognise the bird and see it as accurate. But then, probably my preference goes back to the less accurate ones, and the ones that have had more symbolic meaning. But both are here. They're both here. They're embedded in the work. So she used to draw with her grandfather, she tells us. And my grandmother, too, was a watercolourist. She used to work as an illustrator for Vogue in 1918. That's late to me, don't I? And she taught at Julian National School, and Kay lived in the 10th and James Street here. But my grandmother taught me how to see. She taught me how to look for form, colour, patterns, the shape of things, in a way. And I think that's what Kay learned from her uncle. There's a way, this does not talk in schools. this is the way artists part on, their peculiar way of teaching. And I found it interesting that she went to the James Street Tech, and there are a whole lot of other people who are well known to you here with her as students. And each of them has evolved in their own individual way. It's not the school that makes the person. I worked in education at UWA for years and years, and I'll say this again and again, the teachers can be fantastic. They can open doors that have never been done before. But if you want to be an artist, it's people you love who will influence you more than professionals. So Kay's got the best of both worlds. She's got the professional skills to actually try out new techniques of her own, and that's important. She is a skilled artist. That's something these days. You know, it's something we said. But she's using them to make her own creative works. I am fascinated by the techniques. Now I've forgotten the fumage. Yeah. I've got it right?
Well done.
Oh, I didn't write it down. I knew I'd forget it. The lovely use of the smoke smudges on these owls over here. They're so delicate, and it's part of her belief that fire is the element of life in our country. And now it's becoming more watery because water is as important as fire. But the smoke smudges on the fumage here are important. What I love too is the embossing. It's very, very subtle in these. They are older paintings, these ones here, where she has actually.
About 2 months.
Oh, but
it's all done in 4 or 5 minutes.
Yeah. I've seen this stuff like this, and I love it at the Open Studios exhibition. But it's becoming more subtle now. It's growing in its depth. So now we have got the maps and the old the maps at the back as well as the embossing, and we're now including the natural plants over here in these watercolours here. Very clever. I want to find out how she does this one. It's just really very skillful. A technique she learned. No, by herself. You taught yourself that. But the whole art of printing, the whole art that she was trained in, enabled her to go and use it for her own style and develop her own style. And I think she really impressed it. So I think she's idiosyncratic in her use of the technique, but she's clever enough be recognised as a professional artist, and she's won many, many prizes. I've got the list here. I didn't write them down because there were too many of them. But the Women in Little Stories Art Prize in 2014 in Margaret River, People's Choice Man of Art Prize, shortlisted for Surface Point Art Project, Honourable Mention in the Vass Art Award, Overall Winner Signature Southwest. None of this appears on the website, you'll notice, on Jahroc's website. She's modest. Second prize painting category, Waterhouse Natural History Prize. Interesting. It's real. Acquisitive award for Southwest Survey, City of Bunbury Art Collection. She's in collections, in the Bunbury City Collection, the Sons of Gwalior Green Bushes Collection. I didn't know they had one. The Bustleton and Shire Collection, Shire Augusta Margaret River, and numerous private collectors. That is the mark of a professional, qualified artist. But what I love is it's not just that. This is magic stuff. This is stuff I can relate to, especially the owl ones. I just warm to them. They're absolutely fabulous. And that probably is, to me, what visual art really does. It makes us celebrate our natural world. Through the skills that Kay has, I am blessed by her portraiture of these birds. I welcome you to the exhibition, and I declare it open. Is that what I have to say?
Yeah.
So we will say a little bit more, Kay, like say
yes,
a few words.
I'll just say a few thank yous. This is my first solo exhibition, and I am very honoured to have been invited by Gary and Lara and Dave and Joe to hold this exhibition. I think it's such a fantastic gallery because we get local people, we get national and overseas visitors. So I'm able to show my work to a very wide audience. I'd also like to thank my colleagues and friends and family who give me lots of feedback about my work. I work at TAFE, so I've got lots of colleagues that are here tonight. when I started doing my art, I went to art school at 15, and not long after I met my husband Bill, so he knows what art is all about. And he puts up with many sort of talks about art, and when we've travelled overseas, we go to different art galleries, and he loves it too, so I'm very lucky. And then I've got fantastic framers in Dunsborough. And they, we have lots of jokes, especially about ice cream, because Simo's is around the corner. And they've tricked me a few times and told me it's closed, and I've driven past and it's not closed. I still get my ice cream on the way back from the framers. But they have been very good in discussing how I'm going to frame the work, and especially these frames up here with the maps. You know, I took a chance and I love them, and lots of people love them as well. So thank you everybody for coming tonight. It's so fantastic to see all my friends and family here and my supporters, and have a good evening. Thank you.
And as I said before, we're very pleased and excited to have you working. First solo show here. So I'm even more excited. So enjoy the work. Feel free to buy as much as you like. And have a great night. Thank you.